Good morning, everybody. It's Levon Howard, the host of the Woman 12-2 Experience Radio Show, coming to you live in studio for Saturday, December 7th, 2018. I pray that everyone had a good week this week, despite the cold weather. We made it to the second Saturday in the month of December. I'm praying that everyone is focused and ready to close out 2018 in a great way, and that those things that hindered you from early this year do not stop you from being the person that God calls you to be. We have a great show today, live today. We have Lydia Robinson, the host, is the CEO and founder of Snap Company. She will be a guest at the show at the bottom of the hour. So we will get to cover topics here. I'm going to address something that became a topic yesterday. We'll get to our show. I pray that people that are on here on Facebook Live hit the share button. It's live. Hit the share button right now. For those listening right now, Niche, how you doing? Samara, Natasha, thank you so much. On Instagram Live, Levon1021. And also, if you are listening on the radio, go to Google Play, download the Well App Live Direct Marketplace. And then once you download that, click on Soul Purpose Radio. They'll be live right now for this great show. We're going to close our 2018 strong. We here in the mind, body, and spirit. We just thank God for just being God all by himself, because he's worthy to praise despite what we go through, what's good or bad. He's still worthy to praise. Amen. So we're going to go to our scripture foundation, which is Romans 12:2, which says, "Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by renewing your mind. Then you're able to test and prove what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will." Now, our next scripture will come from Exodus 14:14, which says, "The Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still." Deuteronomy 31:8 says, "The Lord himself goes before you and will be with you. He will never leave you nor forsake you. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged." And Romans 8:38-39, which says, "For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation, we are able to separate us for the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord." There's a scripture reading for Romans 12:2, Deuteronomy 31:8, Exodus 14:14, and Romans 8:38-39. And like I said, we're going to be transparent. We're going to be real. We're going to be honest with the people I have on my show. We're going to have candid conversations on things that you may not see in the community every single day. So the one thing I want to readdress real quickly is that came to the topic yesterday was the Kevin Hart situation. As you may or may not know, Kevin Hart was announced to be the host of the Oscars in February. But on yesterday, he did the opportunity because of some tweets he said about homosexuals and the LGBTQ community eight, nine years ago, and he apologized for that multiple times, but he still announced that he would not have had the opportunity. And I want to say this to Kevin Hart and all his followers out there, that he had a great opportunity passing by. I know that he made a mistake 9, 8 years ago with his tweets, but all of us have made mistakes. All of us have fallen short. All of us have said something that we kind of regret at the time. But if he apologized multiple times and moved forward with his life and didn't work in the community, then why should he be forced to renege on opportunity? And I think Kevin gave them what they wanted, to not get the opportunity to host the Oscars. And I think that we as a culture have to let things go. We are not perfect human beings, ladies and gentlemen. We are falling short multiple times. We have a president that called a quarterback SOB. He's still president of the United States. But we can't. We are hard on Kevin Hart for something you said 9 years ago, and he apologized and grew from that. So it's very, very imperative as a culture that if someone repents for their sins, when they apologize, let them heal. Let it go for your other side and move forward in your life. We are sick and tired of people being judged and valued for the mistakes they have made in our community. And now once we say something in the atmosphere, we make mistakes. This is why I keep telling people all the time, whether you're on Twitter or Facebook or LinkedIn, that I learned from Herman Edwards. He talks about don't press send. Don't press send. And you got to be mindful what the consequences will be, whether it's good or bad or different. Be mindful of what you say because it may affect somebody. So you got to understand, ladies and gentlemen, that you have to understand that this is real. This is not a joke. We got to be mindful of what we say to one another, what we post, what we tweet out there because it's going to get out there. It's going to be found, it's going to be found in the ground. So if you made a mistake, please repent, be forgiven, and do the work to show that you have forgiven yourself. And the people that hold these things are on top of folks, you got to stop it. You got to let it go, move forward. You got to let go, let them move forward. If they apologize, if they repented, if they made an effort to repent for their sins, it's more than saying, I'm sorry, but it's about doing the work to show that you're sorry, that back up your words. And we got to let, and I wish Kevin Hart stayed as a host because even though it might be controversial, but it got big ratings for the show, all of a discussion about what we need to say and I want to say and not to say. I know we want to be transparent, honest all the time, but sometimes you gotta think about what you say before you send or record or tweet, whatever. Be mindful of what you say because you never know what ramifications of that will be look like. Let's hold these people accountable. And if they did something wrong and they apologize and they're remorseful for it, let them move forward. Seriously, let them move forward. All right, now I'm going to go to our review for this week. As you probably may not know, I do reviews of people that came to my schools this week and did the work in our community. As you know, I've been still found a path to greatness. We've been doing it 5+ years. It's going to be 6 years and almost a month. And I'm going to get to more of that later in the show. But I want to thank these people. I want to thank Mike Burrow and Janice Perez for speaking on JDB on Wednesday morning on forgiveness. I want to thank Mike Burrow, Nesley Grace, Anaya's Mission, Muriel and my wife from Seasons for Success for speaking at Webster on this past Thursday on financial literacy. And also Leslie and Bernice were speaking at Ethel Island on this past Friday on financial literacy again, and yours truly speaking at Waspel High School on Monday morning about how to the senior class, how to do a better senior project. Now, I'm going to say this will only real with y'all who know me, that may know me, that I take my work seriously with our youth. And I am overtired, I'm beyond tired, I am sick and tired of our leaders letting our youth down. It came to pass yesterday that two of my students, Alvin, asked about two men that were asking about them to come. And I couldn't give them explanation about why they could not be there for the session. And it's very, very telling that if your presence matters, ladies and gentlemen, your presence matters. If you say you're going to do something for our youth, keep your word. Don't let nothing or nobody deter you from speaking to our youth, unless it's a car accident or a family emergency. There's no more excuses. Our youth need you. They need your presence. They need your voice. They need your common influence on them. Our youth are dying every single day, whether it's physically, verbally, spiritually, emotionally. If you say you're going to do something, be there, be there. Stop hurting our youth. And once you don't keep your word, you miss all your blessings. God will not bless you. He hurt one of God's children. So I challenge anybody on listening to Facebook Live, Instagram Live right now at the moment to please keep your word when it comes to our youth. I don't care. Unless it's a family emergency, unless you got a car accident or something in your hospital, keep your word. Our youth needs you. And you may if you don't understand, they need you right now. They need more than your money. They need more than your gifts. They need your presence. They need your testimony. They need your sins, your burdens, your overcoming of what you had to overcome while you're a teenager to be the person that you are today. We gotta stop this. We gotta stop it. For those who signed up for Path to Greatness, for workshops coming up in the next 2 weeks, please keep your word. If something comes up, please communicate with me early to let me know what's going on. So we're gonna move forward. Our youth need you. Stop playing around. Stop hurting their feelings. Stop hurting their emotions. Once you don't keep your word, it gives them trauma. It gives them trauma. It affects their mental health. It affects their trust. It affects their relationship. It affects the community. It affects the schools. It affects me as a business person. That I'm doing it for God. That's my purpose that God called me to do. If you sign up anything next 2 weeks, please honor your word and show up. Keep your word. If there's an emergency or something, please let me know. Life's too short for foolishness. Life is too short for not us keeping our word. Life is too short for people saying they're going to do something, don't do it. It's not on top of this BS. It's garbage. Let's work together and for our youth so we can be better for ourselves and God will bless us based on what we have done. There are many days when I've been tired and have not done felt well that I ain't feel like doing this stuff. But in the day, I have an obligation to God and to the youth I serve to be present. It doesn't matter how I felt. It doesn't matter how much money I had in a bank account. It doesn't matter how much what to eat this morning breakfast. I kept my word because there was a youth out there that needed my presence, needed my voice. But keep your word, please. And when you do that, God will bless you. He will not bless any foolishness. He will not bless you for you making excuses. Keep your word and go forward for our youth because our youth need you. So we'll take a break. We'll come back. We'll play Michael Wilson. Here, All I Need is Roaring 202 Spirits Radio Show on Soul Purpose Radio. All right, welcome back to the Woman Trauma 2 Experience Radio Show on Soul Purpose Radio. This is Levon Howard, the CEO and founder of Patent the Greatness. Welcome back to your show. Again, you're on Facebook Live right now. Hit the share button. Let's get by on the broadcast right now. Please hit the share live button right now. We are live in the studio right now. My guest is here, Lydia Robinson from Snap Company, and she will be here in a few at the bottom out about 10 minutes. So talk about a company, have a conversation about giving your word. Now, also you're on Instagram Live. I'm Instagram Live on Levon1021. Hit go there, go see, hit me live right there as well. Again, also you're on the radio, go on to Soul Purpose Radio, the app via from the Live Direct Marketplace on Google Play. So please listen in and hear what I gotta say, because I'm talking about keeping our word for our youth, and I'm tired of these adults laying down our youth. Hey, Chrissy, how you doing? Waiting for that payment from you. Saying it was last week, so please send me the payment ASAP. All right, now we're going to talk about this because I, as you may or may not know, I am having an anniversary coming up, which is going to be our 6-year anniversary of Path to Greatness, which will be on January 11th, 2019 at Jasper Studios in North Philadelphia. I'm celebrating 6 great years of Patent the Greatness with people that set the bar for Patent the Greatness going forward. And also, I'm releasing my third book called Transform, Not Conform, The Path to Greatness Story. Basically, my journey from how I got to Patent the Greatness, how I started it. These are advice from all of you. So, I am doing a special, ladies and gentlemen. It's special. So Monday at 10 at 12 p.m. Monday, I was supposed to be tomorrow, but I'm generous. I'm going to expand a little bit. For Monday, 12 p.m., where I'm at, if I'm looking for 6 other people, because someone paid up this morning, which was Cherie Dubois, who was a guest on my show about a month ago, where if you pay for your ticket and for the book, it was a combined value of $40. You will get my first 2 books free, which were released in Patent the Greatness that I wrote 5 years ago for free. I will sign them as well, give it to you at a book signing. Also, you will get a Transform, Not Conform t-shirt, whatever size you fit, you need the shirt. I mean, the best I got was a 2XL. But I need 6 more people to cash on this special offer through Monday. If you do that, you will get my 2 copies of my first 2 books for free, signed by me, and a Transform, Not Conform t-shirt for this at the book signing celebration. You can send the money via PayPal at paypal.me/PatrickGrayness or one word, or a Cash App at PTG11113. Someone just cast it on Magdalene. Sorry about that. And she did an awesome job. And now we are going to go forward with that. So I assist my people to cash on a special deal I'm doing through Monday at 12 p.m. Again, if you pay for your ticket and for my book, my third book, you will get my first 2 books for free and a Transform Not Conform t-shirt for free as well. And let me know what shirt size you want. So the biggest I got is 2XL. I got medium, small, extra large, large for that day. And also, we ask you to donate as well. As that show, I announced that I'm doing a fundraiser for Patrick Greatness to 2019. My goal is to reach $15,000. The reason we're doing that because we're trying to get a van. So we're doing 8th grade college tour. We are doing a youth conference in April called We Believe / Let It Go. We are trying to do our first youth empowerment summer institute for high school students in the summer in June. We are trying to provide more merchandise for our youth. And so we go on trips and events. They can wear our shirts, our brand. And also we wanted to make our events better for our greater, better for our community, which are the Man Talk, Save My Sisters, Office Cafe, and also the PTG Community Day. So we just want to be better in what we're trying to do. This money is not going to me paying bills for our children, for our community, for our events for next year. We will be extraordinary, have great value for the people that come, and also great value for the community. And also for our students as well, to start wearing our shirts, doing our trips, wearing our buttons. So once they go out of the places, they can start talking to people about how, what is Path to Greatness? Hey, what is it about? How can I get involved? Basically, ask a youth that question. Again, I need your help. I can't do this by myself. And plus, I want to bring people on here that are passionate about community. And I'm trying to build a team. I'm trying to build a team where we can grow and take over and impact so many people. And lastly, we want to expand outside Philadelphia. We want to start a program in a Chester, in Canada, New Jersey, Wilmington, Delaware, possibly Baltimore, Maryland. Actually doing some traveling, so do workshops outside Philadelphia. So I believe that some of these youth that we work and serve need our program, need a practice workshop or two to know that, okay, we'll be serious about what we're doing. Again, you can donate, please. You can donate as little as $5. You don't have to, if you want to do more than $5, that's fine. But it's all about our children, it's about our youth, it's about our leadership, it's about our, just take it to another level next year so we can do more and be greater at what we're doing. It's not about getting the fancy cars, it's about providing better quality service than we're already doing right now in our communities. And plus, I want to do more for our youth. I want to do more for our community. I want to bless more of my volunteers more. I want to bless them in their businesses, in their journey. Help them along this journey as well. So, again, I pray that you donate. My goal is $15,000 by January 11th. By January 11th, ladies and gentlemen. I need your help. I need you help. So, I sent an email this morning to people via Google Gmail. I'll put it out today on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and LinkedIn where you can donate. You got more than a month to donate. I'm not asking you for $1 million, but I ask you to make $15,000. That's my goal. So we can do better in 2019 after our book signing. We can start going forward with what we try to do for next year. Try to do things outside the box to be greater and bring people that want to be part of my team. Help me think better, think clearly, and be better. Also, make this radio show better too. Make the radio show better too. We maybe go out and travel, do get sponsorships. Whatever that thing is, make me be better. Make Patagonia better for me and for my youth. And for the community that we serve. North Philly, Lostboro, Frankfurt. Do all these extraordinary things that God's called me to do. So again, you can donate via PayPal, donate.paypal.me/PatrickGreatness1 and also our Cash App at PTG11113. So I'll post that again on my Facebook page and LinkedIn, Instagram today. So don't worry about it. You didn't get those way to donate, but I need your help. I need your support. If you care about our youth, if you care about us being successful and winning together, then donate. Contribute. Pay for the books on it. Be one of seven people. While we have six more people to go since Cherie Dubois did her thing, and donate as well. So please be a support. Be the person that be on the fence for Patagonia 2019. So we can do better, be greater and better, but also make me better as a person and join the movement and join the movement that we are here for our youth. So we'll take a quick break. At that song by William McDowell, Here I Am to Worship, I'm going to have the great Lydia Robinson on my show. We will talk about our nonprofit and then go from there. This is Roman 12-2 Spins Rail Show on Soul Purpose Radio. All right, welcome back to the Roman 12 and 2 Spirits Radio Show on Soul Purpose Radio. My guest is here live in the studio. This is Lydia Robinson. How are you doing this morning?
I'm good. How are you, Levi?
I'm doing great. So you're on Facebook Live, tuning in right now, Facebook Live, Instagram Live, Levon1021, also on the radio at Soul Purpose Radio. Tune in. So if you got any questions or comments for Lydia, please post them on here. We hope we can respond to them, you know, because it's about conversation. Make sure that we are transparent with the audience here. So I met Lydia about a month ago at a youth empowerment event at the YMCA, and me and her connected. And and then she came out to one of my schools in Webster, and she did a workshop on forgiveness for young people. And the young people got a lot from it, and they were asking about, when did she come back? So Keith, before we get to talk about your business and why you're doing it,
sure.
Can you tell us who are you and who are you, pretty much? Like?
Sure. Once again, my name is Lydia Robinson, born and raised in Philadelphia, particularly from the West Oak Lane / Alney section, known as Somerville. I am 33 years old. I am a graduate of Indiana University of Pennsylvania, IUP. I'm also a graduate of Excelsior College, received my master's in business administration, MBA. And currently I am the founder and director of Scene in Actions Productions Company, aka SNAPCO.
Okay, so make sure you talk about SNAPCO. So can you tell us how you get into that? What made you start it? What was the reason behind that?
Sure. So I founded Snap Company in 2012. So basically, it's a performing arts program. And it's also community outreach. And so I wanted to find a way to give back my gifts and my talents to young people. I had a lot of issues as a child, just medically. I was in and out of the hospital a lot. And so I would always remember just seeing, like, the kids that were in the hospital with me and were also patients, just like, the sadness about them. And I would always say, what can I do? Like, I want to do something just to, like, make kids happy. Like, just something just to take away the sadness, you know? And I know I can't do that. But I just wanted to offer something, like, some type of outlet. And I just realized that a lot of our children go through so much, Levon. Like, they're dealing with all types of things. It may be medical issues, it may be family issues, it may be whatever. They're just dealing with things. And I feel like for me as a child, my outlet became arts.
Okay.
So I went to a school where it was very Afrocentric, Ivy League middle school, private school. And so the school was just awesome. Let me just put that out there. But we did a lot in regards to, like, artsy things, artsy movements. My father is a music teacher, so I mean, I come from an artsy background. But once we started doing that in our schools, I started getting involved with that. And for me, it was like, wow, that's it. That's my thing, because I'm not like a talker. So it was like, I found my outlet. And so I created SNAPCO just for that very reason, to offer an outlet to all children. Whether your parents have money or not, you know, we're inexpensive, and it's for all, for everyone to come and just to enjoy themselves.
So what type of events have you done in the 6+ years?
Sure. So every year we have a end of the year production where we invite our family members, our community members to come out, and all our productions have a meaning. So this year our show is called Life in Color. And it's about learning to love yourself, learning to love your complexion, because so many of our participants talk about, oh, I'm light skin, or I'm dark skin, or I don't really like my skin complexion. So we're going to talk about loving ourselves. And so every performance that we do has a very impactful meaning. We've done a lot in our community. Actually, coming up next week, we're participating in the Chestnut Hill Parade. We'll be performing there. We've gone out into family shelters in our neighborhood, and we've done performances there as well. We also offer workshops to kids in low-income neighborhoods and in that underserved at-risk population as well.
So you talk about the love yourself, and that's one of the big things we do
right
here in the community. And one of the things I taught us last week, you kind of brought a comment on self-love,
yes,
especially for our young people, because a lot of times that's a big topic now, but
right.
And a lot of times we didn't want to talk about that. And now we don't talk about it anymore. A lot of kids go through that light skin, go through puberty, go through some of the changes and try to find out who they are. But in the midst of going through that stuff, they'll try to little man say, I love myself, I love my flaws, I love my insecurities. You know what I mean? A lot of times, all of us are not perfect, and all of us are created to do something. If we, once we find ourselves and love ourselves despite our flaws, then we go forward. Yeah. So basically, how can youth get involved in your company? A youth that wants to have an outlet for dance or plays, how he or she get involved?
Sure. So we have two programs. We have a company program, which is performance-based. That's for ages 4 to 13. We're located at the Finley Recreation Center. That's in Mount Airy. And to be a part of that, basically, your parent can go online. It's www.snapcompany.org. They can register with that. We open registration back up this upcoming August. We run that through the school year, so we meet every Wednesday and every Friday for that, for the performance program. And then we have an outreach program where our staff, we go out and we produce various workshops for kids. So we partner with other organizations, so I know we're going to be doing something soon. And we'll go out and we'll offer some dance and theater classes for youth as well.
Okay, so what do you see the future of Snap Company in the next 3 or 5 years? Where do you see of it going? We want to see it.
I want to say expansion. Like, I definitely want to expand. This year has been a phenomenal year for SnapCo. We've grown a lot, tremendously. We've done a lot in different communities. We've been in Germantown. We currently have a program going in Germantown. We also have a program in Hunting Park. I'm starting in January. So I would like to expand. We want to go into those low-income neighborhoods, really. Like, we really want those children to have an opportunity. Because dance school can be expensive.
Yes.
Like, my parents was putting out money for me to dance.
Yes.
Costumes and all that. It's expensive. Yes. So we want everyone to have an opportunity. Boys, girls, everyone, no matter how much money you have, we'll work with parents. So we want everyone to be involved. So we want to expand within the next couple of years, going into various communities in the tri-state, not just here in Philadelphia, Delaware, New Jersey. Hit us up.
Right. So we're going to actually talk about that more. We're going to talk about the topic of today, was to keep our word. Because a lot of times that has done damage to our communities, our schools, our relationships, our family. So we're going to talk more about that. Mm-hmm. So if you want to get involved, go to www.snapco.com for more information.
Snapcompany.org.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay. We have a lot of names. So snapcompany.org.
Snapcompany.org. We get more information on Lydia and what she's doing. She just mentioned we're going to work together in 2019. We got something planned. Mm-hmm. So get more exposed to people that are doing extraordinary things, and also that will be consistent for our community. So we'll take a quick play. We're going to have Hezekiah Walker play All My Help, and then we're going to come back with the conversation about Keep My Word. This is a One Control to the Spirits Rail show on Soul Purpose Radio. She's in my book song.
Yeah, she's one of my mentors.
She came up, she spoke at on Snap Fight.
Yep.
In March.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
Hi,
Kayla.
I'm all on your
live, Leah. Yeah, I know. I'm trying. Hey, man, I don't know who you are. Like, who are you? Yeah, but we're gonna have a lot. So we got the whole thing coming up. We got Fish Up. We doing something on next week. Got the PGG honors and the month.
I saw.
Yeah, so that's a free event.
Okay.
So if people know what kind of grade is, okay, you can see it. Also have youth there, it's gonna be honored.
Okay.
So one of the kids who used to come to school is my program.
What date is that again?
The 28th.
Of this month?
Yeah, okay. So the Friday. It's afternoon.
Oh, like 12 o'clock.
12 to 3.
Okay, that's good.
Yeah, so that's not just gotta be my own phone, so try to make sure that it's basically a free event. So basically get people involved, you know what I mean? To celebrate our people that we honored this year, also have you share what they came, what's better, some people to invest, so I'm like, oh, people get that both kind of ratings and share. Right. It's gonna get a better standard.
Yeah. So I agree. So we'll donate for your book event.
Yeah. Yes,
I won't be at the event because it's the day of our class. So we have classes Friday, Wednesday and Friday. So
what time to get over there?
We start 7, we're done at 8:30.
Oh, 7? Okay, yeah, I'm telling you.
Yeah. We're at night, we're late. Oh, okay. On Fridays. On Wednesdays, we do hours 6:45. So
okay.
Yeah, try to give enough time for the parents to get home and get to the recreation center and drop their kids off. And they get like an hour and some change and they come back and pick their kids up.
Because like I said, we were talking about the UConn, so I'm trying to see if we can do y'all gonna do a workshop or conference.
Okay.
Like, man, so something like that.
Absolutely.
You know? So,
please let us know.
Yeah, so.
We'd love to get our staff, we'd love to be involved, so absolutely.
So. Yeah, we're doing a lot, man. We're doing a whole lot, you know, so.
Oh, he said we get here.
Oh, yeah.
We're on a commercial break.
Right, yeah.
Australia, she's funny.
Yes. On Nino.
Yes.
Yeah, she actually left. She got two. Yeah.
She came when I was moving out.
Right.
Right, Aisha.
All right, welcome back to the Roman 202 Experience Radio Show on Soul Purpose Radio. This, again, we have Lydia Robinson, the CEO and founder of Snack Company.
Yeah.
So, I want you to talk about keep your word. Also, you say she just did a session with Patty Greatness a couple weeks ago. And can you tell us, the audience here who may not got involved with Patty Greatness, what was that experience like for you?
Oh, that was such an awesome experience. We were at, what was the name of the school?
Webster.
Webster Elementary School. And fifth grade,
right? fifth grade.
And they were phenomenal. We talked about forgiveness, and to be honest, I was mind blown because that's not talked about a lot with our youth, especially at that age. And so understanding that what forgiveness is, and LaVon did an awesome job of breaking it down to them. And then we just had a good feedback. A lot of them got to talk about their hurt and their experiences they had that was hurtful, and some of them never forgave. And so we talked about how forgiveness is just not only for the other person, it's for them as well. And a lot of them understood it. We took it to their level, and it was great. So I advise that you guys get involved with Path to Greatness and share your input with these children, because trust me, they will really like take it all in.
And plus, what we do is we do our subject that way uncomfortable, that it's not talking about, like, unless something happens, the community, even if some community they won't talk about, we did something on mental health, and yes, we did financial literacy.
Right.
You know what I mean? Even like, so we try to do more, so that's why we try to make sure we can do a whole year, I was like semester doing more workshop, because our youth needed stuff. Okay. They need that stuff to help them grow, help them be better, you know. And I hope that people get more involved, because that's what we are doing. self-love, our last session of a couple of schools, and then next week with Flesh and Celebration, where you tell us what they got for the program. Mm-hmm. So some of the schools are also like kind of the full year. Right. So they got like, you know, so we all try to do more subjects that may be uncomfortable that need to be addressed, like domestic violence, things like that. So one of the things I want to talk about, we kind of through our schools is kind of keep your word. Mm-hmm. And that word, that statement has really hindered our communities, our relationships, our family dynamics, our community down managers, our business partners, trying to build that. So what's your perspective on us keeping our word? Because I spoke over earlier this show, and especially when our adults say they're going to be there for our youth and let them down, and youth feelings hurt, they get the trauma, you know, they get feel like they can't trust anybody. So can you expand on that based on your perspective from that? So
absolutely. So I love the phrase, be the change that you want to see. And so for me, I want to see such a change in our young people. Like, our young people are dealing with so much, they're going through so much. It's just a crazy world that we're living in today. And so in order to be that change, I have to be there. We have to be present. We have to be seen. And children are so impressionable. They are. From young children on up to teenagers, even though they can be a little rough, but they're impressionable. I mean, I've worked in high schools for a few years, and just some of the young girls, the way that they would take me in, like, you know, some of them would, not lying, they would come with the same hairstyle as me. So it would be like, all right, like, you trying to be like me a little bit? But it's funny, but when you step back and look at it, you're like, wow, I'm really making an impression on these children, right? And so I think that it's important that if we're going to come in, and then if we're going to help make a difference in these young people's lives, and that we're going to be an example for them, or set an example for them, we need to be there, right? We need to be there. We need to be in the presence. And so when we say, hey, I'm going to be there, I'm going to come speak to a child or a group of children, that we're there, because they're looking for us. They're looking for us. Our kids deal with rejection every day. They deal with people turning their backs on them all the time, at home, in school. And so I just think that it's important that if we say that we're going to be there for our kids and do something, and we know life happens, right?
Right.
Something can happen and come up. But let's just try to be there, because they really are counting on us, and they really are looking up to us to help them in making a difference.
Right, I agree. And plus, also, we also got tired, because you never know what that youth went through that whole week or day to get ready.
Right.
Because a lot of them had a bad week, and then you never know. Your presence might be the healing place or that saving grace, you know.
Absolutely.
That's why it's very powerful that once we turn down something, that's why we really take the heart when people don't show up for our youth, but once they say they're going to do something, because you never know what that youth that's looking for you dealt with. Even though they may not say it sometimes, they know what they dealt with to get to that school, and they know that, hey, this person's coming to school that day, you know.
Yeah.
Or, you know, it's very important that you keep our word. That's why we're glad you came and showed up, and because our youth, they need someone different. They need someone to say, oh, wow, she been through this too.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of times we human too. We deal with emotions. We deal with people let us down, and that forget. And then plus, once they do that, we can come. The forgiveness part comes in.
Mm-hmm.
We tell them forgive. Hey, listen, they made a mistake.
Right.
They made it up. They showed up. You know, for like that. So it's very important that our youth are heard, and like they are being valued, because a lot of them are not being valued right now. With all the shoes going on and
everything.
So we gotta value our youth more. From those even to high school seniors, they are very vital to our community. I believe that they are the now generation, not the future. They are the now. So like, I mean, we want to support them, to help them do what they were called to do, whatever that is, and help them get to that place and not force them to be something they're not, but be what they were called to be. You know, whatever that is, it may sound outside your realm. But help them, get them resources, help them be present, you know what I mean? Because you're present, you go to vent, do a session, or not even say a word, but you show up, that means a whole lot.
Yeah.
That means a whole lot for our youth, that'll look at their day, their spirits, because you know that Miss Robinson came for them, and they made their day, they may have one day at school.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like,
I deal with that a lot, like, especially with our program, with
okay.
Sampo. we have some of the kids, like, and so that's a lot what our program is all about. Like, yeah, dancing and acting is all fun, but really at the end of the day, we want to make sure that we're making an impact on our kids. We want to make sure that we're loving on them. We want to make sure that they know that they're loved by us, by our staff members. And so one thing that's important is when they come in through the door, the first thing I'm asking is, like, how's your day? Mm. What happened? Like, right. Tell me. And actually, like, Wednesday, I had a girl. She was just, like, coming in the door. She was mad at her mom. Like, she's like, can you get her Miss Lydia? She got attitude problem. And I'm just like, well, maybe she had a rough day. And I pulled her to the side. I said, you had a rough day? And she said, yeah, I did, actually. And I said, all right, tell me about your day. And she began to tell me about a little boy that was bothering her in school. And so we talked about solutions to that. Like, how do we go about so that no longer happens to you? So our kids deal with a lot, and I don't think it's something we should take for granted at all. And so I agree with you. It is important that we're there and that we say, if we're going to do something, that we come through and do it, because we don't want to abandon our kids. They're already dealing with so many issues. So try to the best of the ability to be there for our babies.
And then a lot of times, a lot of the kids are doing things that the adults shouldn't have been dealt with. That had dealt with when they were younger. So
yeah.
A lot of them are dealing with adult problems, and they know it's 6, 7 years old. They can't be a kid. So, right. And a lot of times our kids are being adults when they can't even be a kid and go outside and play real games and learn new things, because they got to take an adult role, because adults and adults are not responsible for it or not doing what they supposed to do to go forward. So, it's very, very powerful that this program, Snap Company, gets more exposure in terms of what we're trying to do in the community, because always trying to get the schools I work with to get exposed to people that are doing great things. And I think you're doing great things and also doing things that are outside the box. A lot of times our youth, for what I see, they're always on their phones or...
Oh, you know, tell me about it. Those phones, my goodness. Like, especially teenagers. But you know what? You know, the children had phones. So it's like, okay, I didn't have a phone until I was like 20. Like, I'm keeping it real. Like, until I went to college, I didn't have a phone. And the kids laugh at me when I say that. But we have to get, and I just was having this conversation the other day, we have to get them out of that, because they don't know social skills. They don't know how to interact with each other. And so we have to make sure that we are getting our children involved in different programs, like my program, like your program, so many other nonprofits and other organizations. We have to get our kids involved, because all they know is the phone. And that's scary. Like, this is our future, y'all. Like, we got to be in their faces. We have to be present. So it's so important, guys, that we're there as adults, just to say, hey, I'm here for you. Let's talk. Let's get you involved. Let's interact. What do you like to do? Let's meet them at their needs.
Right. Yeah, I agree. Then go back to the phone. Man, I phone to all my in my freshman year.
Me too.
I was 19. I had to take an incident to find out get my phone. Right. It wasn't like I asked for a phone. It was like,
happened to you, and then the same thing with me. Something happened to me, and they go, we got to get her a phone now. And I'm like, okay.
Yeah. It's funny, I went to spring break. I went back home spring break, went back to school. On the way back to school on spring break, my suitcase broke. So I used a payphone back then, like a payphone back then.
Right.
The mom was like, ooh, that's a red flag. Right.
So I had 5 quarters.
So I got home for the summer. My mom gave me a phone. It was actually the voice free phones, the big Nokia phone.
The
first phone I had was that. Every year I had voice free for T-Mobile. So like before they showed T-Mobile. Yeah, so that back then, we had to talk to people. We had to actually talk on the phone. Some people had to actually woke back then. They had to write how they felt. That's for me. I was shy. I like how I felt to people. You know what I mean? I know if I talked back then, it wouldn't come out right.
Right.
That's why I express my wish for
right. So you were right. And it's similar for me. I know when I say this, everybody gonna be like, yeah, right. But I was shy too. I still am. I have a shot. I'm a person who really would like rather to be behind the scenes. And so I know everybody who's watching is probably like, she's lying. But seriously, so when I found dancing and when I found theater and the stage at my school, that for me was like, I can come out of my shell. But off stage, I'm going to be quiet, little Lydia, but on stage. And so it's important that our children find their voice and they find something that they enjoy and that, you know, it's an outlet for them as well. Not the phones.
The phones, we ain't assessing. I mean, we ain't assessing. They have sessions with the kids on their phones. I'm like, what are you doing? Like, can you turn your phone off, please? Like, it's like, It's like some of them are so attached to the phone.
So
it's like affects their mindset, affects their brain. And I tell people all the time, because that's why what we want to do in the summertime was actually do a trip outside fully, but the kids don't bring their phones at all. No. So when they can find out, they find out who they really are outside their phones,
mm-hmm.
and that'll give them exposure. And they'll actually find it help them reveal who they really truly are.
Mm-hmm.
So. We went past the 12 o'clock hour. Thank you for those who have been watching and listening on Facebook Live, Instagram Live, on our way on app. Do you have any final words for us today? Words of encouragement as we close here today?
Sure. I'm just going to say to all the young people who are watching, not just young people, adults as well, whatever it is that you want to do in life, just go ahead and do it. Don't let anyone stop you. Just go after your dreams. And also to our adults, I'm just asking if you can please make sure that you're involved in our young people's lives, just even if it's just affirmations daily, something, because our kids are really out here dying and we need you. So that's all. God bless.
Yes, very, very important. So again, thank you so much for being guest on my show.
You're
going to see me more of her in our program, Repat Advance in 2019 with her program, Snack Company. So we are doing some stuff with them. We're going to try to make sure they are in our schools doing program for our kids, because I feel like that's very important that they pour into us. We get an opportunity for them to bring it forward to their school, you know, and help our youth there. So we're very, very important that we understand that. So next week we're going to have Kiara Moda as a guest on our show. And then also I want to say one more time that also December 28th we're going to do PTG Honors. We are honoring people for the great work 2018, and we are going to, it's a free event. It's going to be at the Free Library in Philadelphia. You can register for a ticket at bit.ly, bit.ly/PTG Honors 2018, R1 Fame for a free ticket. We have free refreshments. Also, we have youth there talking about their experience of this past year and how you get more involved. So, we're very, very excited about what we are doing. So, again, please pray for one another. Pray with each other. Yes. Keep God first. Be humble and grateful for what you have done. And do something positive today. And also, for that you think over adults, say an affirmation to our youth.
Yes.
Say something that they say they're great. Say they're smart. Okay. They're smart what they've been through. So, again, enjoy your Saturday. Stay warm. Be safe. Keep God first. And then we will see you next week on the Woman Trial 2 Experience radio show.
Kia. Hi, Miss Kia. Kia is one of our dancers.